Today class, we can see the factors affecting quality seed production. It covers various factors like climate, edaphic, it means soil factors, biotic factors, production technology and post-harvest handling of seeds. Now we can see one by one. The climatic factors have direct bearing on the quality seed production. This includes light, that is duration, intensity and photoperiod. Then temperature, it includes low, moderate, high and very high temperature. Then rainfall or snowfall and wind, that is direction and velocity of the wind. Climate is the most important factor, and generally for seed production, dry temperate climate is most suitable. The various factors affecting quality seed production can be divided into three. First one is agroclimatic factors or ecological factors, that is edaphic and climatic factors. Then second one is production technology, and third one is post-harvest handling of seed. The ecological factors or agroclimatic factors. The environmental factors include adaptability of the variety or hybrid to environment, temperature, day length, light, wind, rainfall, dew, frost and relative humidity. The agroclimatic condition of plant ecology includes temperature, rainfall, sunshine hours, dew point, wind velocity and rainfall. Normally, seed crops are sown in three different seasons to suit the best agroclimatic condition for production of quality seeds. They are Kharif season, that is June to September, then Rabi season, October to January, then summer season, it is February to May. Now we can see about major factor for consideration in selection of agroclimatic conditions are: the crop variety to be grown for seed production must have suitable agroclimate adapted to the photoperiodic, that is short days and long days, and temperature conditions prevailing in that location. The regions with high rainfall, humidity and extreme temperatures are not suitable for seed production. Next one is, most of the agronomic crops require a dry sunny period and moderate temperatures for flowering and pollination. Coincidence of high wind during flowering results in poor seed set, and excessive dew and rains affect the normal pollination, resulting in poor seed set, and also extreme temperature may cause the desiccation of pollen and poor seed set. Several crops, especially vegetables, legumes and fruit crops, which fail to set seed during very hot and dry weather conditions and adversely affect the flowering. These crops invariably require cooler climates with low atmospheric humidity to flower and pollinate normally. Then the oil seed crops may tolerate hot weather during flowering, but very high temperatures can result in premature flowering and the production of poor quality seeds. And the excessive rainfall conditions normally result in a higher incidence of pest and disease, making the harvesting and other operations of seed production extremely difficult. They may also cause the delayed maturity and pre-germination of seeds in many standing crops. Changes in seeds character and influence on seed quality due to climatic factors. We can see various examples for change of climate. In case of kambu and sorghum, the rainfall or high humidity at maturation leads to blackening of seed due to black mold fungal attack, which affects the low physiological quality. In kambu, heavy wind at flowering leads to tip sterility and low seed set. But in case of pulses, rainfall at maturation means it produces off-colored seeds that have low germination and storability. High humidity at maturation leads to mottled seed and lesser physiological quality in peas. In case of brinjal, high temperature at the flowering produce pseudo-styled flowers that have poor seed set and lesser physiological quality. In case of vegetables like tomato, chilies and brinjal, the rainfall at maturation leads to decayed fruits and soiled fruits have low germination and vigor. Then next factor is edaphic factors, that is soil factors. To be successful farmer, one must first know the nature of the soil. Normally, for seed production, fertile soils are generally preferred. Soil pH should be around 7, but should not be alkaline in nature. Mostly, pH affects seed production in sensitive plants like legumes and vegetables. Higher pH also reduces the availability of micronutrients like zinc, boron, and magnesium. The problem soil like saline soil, acidic soils are to be avoided for seed production. Ill-drained soil also causes chlorosis in corn by affecting absorption and wilt disease in tomato and chilies. The soil should be free from soil-borne pathogen and nematodes, especially for seed production in horticultural crops. So, soil should have adequate macro and micronutrients for producing vigorous and viable seeds. Some of the examples for micronutrient deficiency. The boron deficiency causes black rot in coal crops, particularly cabbage and cauliflower. Molybdenum also causes the whiptail in cruciferous family. Excess nitrogen leads to prolific vegetative growth, making them prone to disease and insects, thus resulting reduction in seed quality and yield. The NPK and balanced dose increases seed yield and improves the seed quality and induces the resistance. For producing quality seeds, disease-free seeds, soil should be well-drained, fertile and free from pathogens. For example, bacterial wilt inoculum available in most soils infest solanaceous vegetables like tomato, brinjal and chili. Fusarium wilt in many vegetables spread from seed to soil. Wilt gets established through planting material and thus spreads further from the soil. Soil should also be free from weed seeds. Therefore, soil should have optimum moisture, good texture and structures. Different vegetables have different soil requirements and in general, loams are best for seed production. Next factor is climatic factors. The first one is adaptability. This relates to better survival capacity of a variety under changed or given environmental conditions. Seed crop must always be sown in their areas of adaptation. Nucleus and breeder seed crops must strictly be sown in their areas of release, while foundation and certified seeds can be grown widely. In Tamil Nadu, there are 7 agroclimatic zones that are to be judged for raising the seed crop. The next factor is wind. Wind is necessary for pollination in wind-pollinated crop. It improves seed setting in highly cross-pollinated crop like onion and crucifers. Heavy winds may carry pollen too far or prevent the deposition on stigma, thus reducing the seed set. Winds are also a source of contamination and protection of seed crop has to be done using barriers. Dry winds also desiccate pollen, losing its viability and also causes desiccation in legumes, resulting in hard seeds. And the heavy winds dislodge the seed production crops and seed loss through shattering of seeds or pods. Temperature. The temperature plays a major role in seed production. Optimum temperature is required from the day of harvest. For example, coal crop seed production requires low temperature, that is 4 to 10 degree centigrade at initial stage, and high temperature, that is 15 to 20 degree centigrade at reproductive stage, that during seed development and maturation period. Too high temperature causes desiccation of pollen, resulting in poor seed set and quality. High temperature adversely affects seed production in lab, cowpea, pulses in general due to candubescence, drying of anthers. Flower shedding in pulses, tomato, chilies and production of higher percentage of hot seeds in pulses. Higher temperature and strong winds causes desiccation of pollen grains and drying of stigma, result in poor seed set and seed quality. Overwintering or chilling or vernalization is needed for cabbage, cauliflower, beetroot, carrot, turnip, etc. in order to shift from vegetative to reproductive place, which helps in quality seed production. Higher temperature results in shriveling of seeds, lower yield and poor seed quality in bleaching of peas. Temperature between 24 to 38 degree centigrade is most favorable for activities of pollinators, particularly bees. Pollinators are an important component in vegetable seed production, and without this, quality seed production is not possible, particularly in cross and often cross-pollinated vegetables. The pollinator stops working at low, that is below 20 degree centigrade, or high temperature beyond 30 degree centigrade, heavy rains and strong winds, which hampers the quality seed production. Humidity. Higher relative humidity, that is more than 90% during maturation, will lead to production of light colored seeds in peas. Then alternate wetting and drying results in dimpled seeds in peas, French bean, cluster bean, and high humidity causes heavy flower drop. Higher relative humidity also reduces the storage potential, and it increases the seed moisture during storage and leads to higher incidence of pest during storage. Flowering, pollination, and seed setting in temperate vegetable needs low humidity and dry weather at maturity, and moderate to low humidity in sub-temperate and tropical vegetable varieties. High humidity and temperature encourages production of diseased seeds. Slightly warm, dry climate is suitable for production of disease-free seeds. Rainfall. Apart from affecting pollination, the excessive rainfall leads to a higher incidence of disease, result in mold attack and seeds discoloration and bleached seeds in peas. It may also result in delayed maturity and pre-germination or sprouting of seeds in many standing crops like peas and beans, etc. Precocious germination may result in pulse crop. Rainfall during harvest will lead to lodging of seed crop, thus rejection of seed field. The seeds from lodged crops germinate and lose vigor rapidly and prone to disease infection. Strong wind and heavy rainfall at or near harvest may cause heavy seed losses in scattering of seed crops and also complicate the harvesting, threshing and drying operations. For example, activity of pollinators, that is bees, is practically nil during rainy time and flowers are wet. Next factor is biotic factors. What are all the biotic factors included for seed production? It includes insect activity, disease and role of microorganisms. First, we can see about insect activity. Insects are beneficial as well as harmful in seed production. In alfalfa, the alkali bees are reared to increase the dripping. It is the mechanism wherein the alignment of bee on the keel petal pushes forward the stigma which brushes the pollen. In dwarf sunflower, rearing 6 honeybee hives per hectare increases the seed production by 30%. The crops like Chinese cabbage, nulkol, cauliflower, mustard needs bees to cross-fertilize among the plants to increase the seed set. Insects also damage seed right from the pod stage till harvest and in storage, and account for 20-30% of the seed production losses. Example, in cucur pit, red pumpkin beetle and beetle in pulses are pollen eater. Second one is disease. Disease are caused by fungal, bacterial and viral agents. Most of them are carried either externally or internally. The external pathogens are controlled by seed treatment, but internal pathogens are difficult to treat and eradicate. Extensive care is taken to prevent infection of seed crop through roguing and plant protection operation, and monitored through seed inspection, and all seeds are treated with fungicide before sales or storage to reduce the spread of disease. Role of beneficial microorganisms. The several microorganisms are involved in protecting the seed during germination and subsequent growth. Rhizobium affix the nitrogen, Acetobacter and Azospirillum secrete the plant growth hormones. Next, we can see about production technology, that is role of seed crop management in quality seed production. Successful seed production requires application of good farming practices along with careful management of the crop. In these factors, it includes seed source, isolation, time of planting, seed rate, method of planting, depth of sowing, irrigation, fertilizer application, and nutritional factors, roguing and pest and disease control. Now we can see by one, establishing seed source. It is essential to make a list of breeder or breeding institutions for the supply of authenticated stocks of breeder seeds for further seed multiplication chain. Next factor is isolation. Protect the seed crop from all possible sources of contamination during the growing period by providing the isolation distance. What is isolation distance? As earlier class, I have told that the distance to be maintained between the seed crop and the contaminant or other varieties of the same crop. When isolation distance is lacking, one may adopt time isolation, but it is necessary to ensure that the flowering period of the seed crop and that of contaminant do not coincide. Time of planting and seed rate. The seed crop should invariably sown or transplanted at an optimum age of seedling at their normal planting time. At the time of planting, there should be sufficient soil moisture for germination to take place. Lower seed rate than usual for raising commercial crop are desirable because it facilitates roguing operation and inspection of seed crop. Method of planting or sowing. The sowing of seed crop in rows help in conducting effective plant protection measures and roguing operations and also field inspections. During hybrid seed production, planting of two parents, namely female parent and male parent line, has to be done in a definite proportion of 4:2 or 8:2. Depth of sowing. The depth of sowing is extremely important in ensuring the good plant stance. Small seeds like cucurbits, solanaceous and malvaceous vegetables should usually be planted shallow, but large seeds could be planted a little deeper. Seeds would emerge from greater depths in sandy soils than in clay soils and also in warm soils as compared to cold. In dry soils, seeds should be planted slightly deeper so that they come in contact with moisture. Irrigation. The optimum and timely irrigation is must. Over irrigation can promote vegetative growth, lodging, nutrient imbalance, while under irrigation, delay flowering, stunted growth, reduced filling and immature draying. Hence, irrigation at critical stages like sowing, life irrigation, flowering, fruit and pod formation, seed filling and seed maturation is must. Withholding irrigation at harvest promotes earlier and quicker ripening and also be used for staggering and achieving synchronization in hybrid seed production. Fertilizer application. As I have told in earlier class, the split application is useful compared to total application. The basal and top dressing of 1 or 2 or 3 times depending on the crop duration. Nutritional factors. Lack of N, that is nitrogen, delays the field emergence, and lack of P, that is phosphorus, delays the flowering. K, that is potassium, is responsible for filling and lusher of the crops. And zinc is essential for fertilization. The copper deficiency leads to poor embryo growth. Manganese deficiency causes the marshy spot in peas. Boron deficiency results in poor seed development and hollow heart in groundnut. Then iron deficiency causes sterility and molybdenum also contribute to bleaching in peas. In the nutrition of the seed crop, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium and several other elements play an important role for proper development of the plants and seeds. So, it's therefore advisable to know and identify the nutritional requirements of seed crops and apply the adequate fertilizers. Recommended dose of fertilizers and irrigation must be given to get higher yield. Roguing. Then what is roguing? It is the act of removing off-type plants present in the seed crop. Roguing. In most of the field crops may be done as per the needs of the seed crop. That is vegetative or pre-flowering stage, then flowering stage, fruit or pod formation stage. Roguing at vegetative or pre-flowering stage in cross-pollinated crops is extremely important to avoid the genetic contamination. The roguing at flowering stage is equally important perhaps even more important at the vegetative stage. In hybrid crops, where male sterility is being used, special care is required in the removal of pollen shedders. In many crops, removal of ear hurts or flower stalk infested by seed-borne disease. Roguing at maturity is also equally important in the removal of various contaminants affecting the purity of the seed. In root and vegetatively propagated crops, a roguing at harvest time is done for confirmation of fruit or tuber or root characteristics is necessary. Sometimes inspection is also be attended before seed extraction to select true to type fruits and pods to ensure the genetic purity. Disease and pest control. The seed crop should be maintained without pest and disease attack. The leaf curl virus and yellow vein mosaic infestation drastically reduce the yield and quality in tomato and bendi respectively. The fruit or pod borer infestation causes seed discoloration and result in poor quality in terms of viability and storability. Similarly, the brookid attack in lab leads to very poor storability. There is a heavy damage in flowering and seed set in crucifer vegetables due to diamondback moth incidents. Harvesting and post-harvest handling of crop. Seed well, harvest better. Harvesting and threshing. In vegetables, the harvest are to be taken in different pickings. For getting higher yield, the first and last one or two pickings may be taken for vegetables. This may promote further growth of the plant and put for the more number of fruits or pods. In addition, the seed recovery and quality will be poor in the first and last pickings. From the harvested produce, the seed should be extracted by suitable extraction methods like wet extraction method for tomato, brinjal, bitter gourd, snake gourd, and dry extraction method for bendi, chili, crucifers, ribbed gourd and peas and beans. Drying and grading. Direct exposure of seed to sunlight may affect its quality. Therefore, if necessary, the seed may be dried under diffused sunlight in a shade with the opening on all sides. Artificial drying is done blowing air at 70 to 85 degree Fahrenheit but never exceeding 110 degree Fahrenheit. Grading is done with various types of graders. Seed treatment. Okay, what is seed treatment? The seed treatment with the fungicide and insecticide is done to arrest the carryover of pathogens and insects with the seeds. Packaging, labeling and sealing. It is necessary to use the right type of containers, that is based on the seed moisture content at proper level, the labeling and sealing in the prescribed manner. Movement and storage. Precautions should be taken to avoid seed deterioration while in transit and or in storage. The ideal storage for long term is dry and cool conditions. The ideal conditions can be maintained if the sum of relative humidity and temperature does not exceed 100 degree Fahrenheit. Mechanism of control. The generally adapted system of seed certification involves field inspections, sample testing, also enforcement of minimum standards which constitute the mechanism of quality control in seeds. This is done by seed certification agency. Students, so far we have learnt about agroclimatic factors includes examples for the influence of climate on seed quality, rainfall, temperature, wind, humidity and sunshine, and then edaphic factors, it includes problematic soils, then next biotic factors, it represents insect activity, disease and role of microorganisms, and finally production technology factors, and dealt about harvesting and post-harvest handling of seeds.